So first thing we've got to do is we've got to get our ends ready. We're going to strip off, say 10 mil, maybe a little bit more. I normally eyeball it sort of with a little fingernail. It's normally enough. There's a couple of ways we can do this. Old school, hardcore, Stanley knife, pop it in there and roll this around using your thumb. If you're doing a lot of this, this will have loads of little cuts in the thumb. Yeah, it's not great, not ideal, but in an emergency you can do that. Another method, use a pair of crimp pliers. These are got for crimp terminals, and also they've got the little eyelets in there. My preferred method, it's just quicker, is a set of strippers like this. Gives us exactly what we want. It's fairly easy to use, and this is quite handy when you're in a real life situation, working on the car and in a wiring loom, and you've got to get, if you want to splice onto a wire, you can strip the new wire and then splice onto it without having to cut the original. Makes for a nice neat joint. The downside of this is getting heat shrink on it. Unless you've got this end exposed and you can slide it along, you then have to resort to insulating tape. But however, I've used that on many, many occasions and it's never failed. You can solder together like this. I don't like that. If you think about it, if I twist these together now, it's already stronger before I've gone anywhere near it with a soldering iron. And with my twists, I try and leave the end straight. It gives me just, it makes folding the tips over a little bit easier when you're trying to get it flat. Because what you don't want is a bit sticking up like this. Because when you put the heat shrink on, that can, it'll be quite hard by the time it's covered in solder. You want this nice and smooth. You see, now that holds itself together already. Now if you're using heat shrink in a real world situation, if this is on a car for instance and these ends are made off and connected somewhere and you can't separate them, put your heat shrink on first, because you see the problem, now we can't get it on there. Right, the iron's up to temperature now, but if you look at the tip of it, pretty manky. Now you get little sponges for doing this, but a wet bit of kitchen towel works just as well, and we just rub it in there. This is fairly wet, and then see how that's nicely tinned. Got all that muck off. We don't want to introduce faults into this solder joint. And then what we're looking for is flow. So the main problem I've come across over the years is people didn't get it hot enough, either not hot enough or too hot, because obviously this is plastic rubber, it will melt. So a little bit of solder on the iron to prime it or tin it, and then once that starts getting drawn in, capillary action will pull that into the joint. You see now that starts going silver, and that's good enough. See with the smoke, if you're in a car, you can just blow it out of the way, take the old iron away, give it a clean, we're ready for the next one. Now if you look at that join, it's never going to come apart. Now with your heat shrink, size is key. You don't want it too tight that you can't get it on. And when this is still warm, if you try forcing it on, it will just melt through it. And again, you don't want it too big, because you want this to shrink down nicely and center it. If I have that in the center of the join there now, when that shrinks down, it's going to protect it. Now to shrink this, I've seen people do it with lighters, a naked flame. Don't do that. You'll burn this, it then becomes brittle. And if you're trying to keep moisture out, if this was self-adhesive heat shrink, the glue's going to spread out nicely. But if you heat it up too far, the glue's going to come out. But also this can burn, get brittle, and then you're going to let moisture in. So don't use a naked flame. You can get these for the tip of your soldering iron. which is great. If you've got two, you can have one with this setup already. But in the real world situation, if you've just been soldering with a soldering iron, especially a gas one like this, you can just use the exhaust vent. It's not a naked flame. It's not going to damage anything around the vehicle, and you can just run it across like this. Don't hover too long in one spot, and you'll see it's just shrinking up. Don't overcook it. And there we are. Nicely shrunk down. You can see the twist in the cable there, but that's not coming apart and nothing's getting into it. And more importantly, it's not gonna arc out on anything and shoot them up together. So this is how you get a nice twist. This was shown to me by a guy, an alarm engineer, over 30 years ago now. Strip your cable, but leave this on. Pull it so it's not far from the end, and then use that to turn it, because that will grip it better than your skin and friction can, because it's molded to the shape of it. If you ever looked at the inside of one of these, you'll see it's got all the shape of the cable. Leave the end flat, so if you're wrapping it over something, here's a better example, if you're wrapping it over something, you stand more chance of getting the flat cables or the flat cores to sit down and not spike up, but you've still got the twist that gives you a little bit more strength. I'll show you what I mean. This is a quite thin cable for an old LED. Strip it. Pull it out. Give it a twist. Now, if you were fitting this into a chop block screw connector or something that's going to crush down on this, because it's so thin, you can see how thin this is, it's not going to survive. So solder it. I'll show you what I mean. We just tin this. And then solder that. Capillary action will bring it in. Simple as that, nice and quick. Don't stay on it for too long. Now if we look at the end of this, if you're going to screw that into something or crimp it down, that'll last a lot longer. Copper's really easy to twist, it's got a bit of strength to it now, it's hard to bend. If I put any pressure on this, it's going to bend where the copper is, not where the solder is, so you've increased the strength of it. If you have to splice into a wire, you're picking up a live something, if you're installing something, I won't twist this one. You don't have to twist, it's kind of personal preference really, but you want a nice tight mechanical join before you apply the solder. So twist it round like this. If it's nice and tight like that, then when we stick the solder on it, it's not going anywhere. Give it a clean. And again, tin the iron, transfers the heat quicker, and then you'll see it. There you go, it's gone. It's as quick as that, job done. So this is a tip. It's fairly obvious really if you think about it, but I've seen this time and time again. Someone's joining a couple of wires or splicing into a couple of wires, and they do all their joins exactly the same place. Obviously, if you've introduced bare wires there, and then we're gonna have to insulate and tape this, there's the chance that if this fails, it can join together, and you've made it easy for a fault to occur. So just stagger it. And what I mean by that is, if we trim this back here, you don't have to go far, just enough so they can't physically touch. Because when we re-loom these cables, again, I haven't twisted this one. When we re-loom it, and this is all soldered and we've taped this one, they can't touch. So if the insulation tape fails, it's not going to cause a problem, because this is just going to rub against this and it's already got insulation on it. So we're good to go. So we'll solder this one. Clean your iron. Tin it. And this is a fat cable, so it might take a little bit more heat. Just be prepared for that, especially if we're doing anything around the ignition, fitting accessories, etc. You might have to be a bit brave with the heat. But again, once it starts flowing, you want it to flow like a liquid. Melting is one thing, flowing is what you're interested in. You want the capillary action to draw it through all the strands of cable. Right, now, as you can see, taped up, when these are taped up tight, they can't touch. I've got a bit of a straggler there, but get it out of the way. While it's hot, you can always squish it down, put something hard against it and flatten it. Don't want any spiky bits. And then we'll insulate this with insulating tape. Same again with that one. Then you join both together in the loom. It's not going to cause any problems. But like this, they're all together there. Not only is it can cause problems, but it bunches up. If you imagine you've got a few of these together, that whole loom there is going to be a lot wider than if you stagger them. Man, I feel amazing, being on this highlight every single day. Man, it's like a highlight. This is what I bathe in, excited because I know I'm going in places. Everything I want is coming to me. Getting DMs asking how much for a feature. Tell them if it's right.